Yo.
What's happening with you, bro?
What's up, man? How you feeling, man?
What's going on? Man, you had some pretty valid frustrations early this morning, man.
You know, I woke up, called Tip immediately. Sometimes I feel like we get hit with the okie doke. So I did some research on these black screens that have been going out. And this originated in the music industry. Started off as a blackout in the music industry to fight for rights and for all, you know, music industry employees to not go to work today, stand in solidarity. It kind of took legs. A lot of people have been posting it, and now it's turned into a full-fledged blackout. We've seen it on everybody's page now. A lot of confusion over whether to post, you know, Black Lives Matter, Blackout Tuesday, a lot of different confusion happening there. So then we found out, a lot of us found out that there's an election today. There's a primary election today taking place in some key states with some key, you know, legislation that could take place. So, you know, the whole thing is just, it's become this frustration for a lot of us because we all want information. We all want to get the right information out to people. We all want to make sure that when we're driving traffic and we're leading people in the right place, that we're doing it correctly, especially for you and me as entertainers and people with influencers and followers. We want to make sure that when we post something, it's correct. And part of the frustration that we all experience is that there's so many different pockets of information that's happening right now that, you know, it gets a little convoluted sometimes.
Yeah, I mean, I think what we're experiencing is we have a very broad, diverse set of issues that we're dealing with. It's not just one thing, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
There's a educational disparity. There's an economical disparity. And of course, you know, the police brutality that we all deal with being born a certain shade of brown. So with a multi-layer problem, you have to have a multi-layer approach to a solution. So that's why so many different things. However, we got to remain focused on whatever our initiatives are, whatever primarily, like right now, voting, that's important for the primaries and all, but we can't take light away from the other things that we still have to focus on.
Not at all, man. You said something interesting this morning when we were talking online about just how generationally things have happened. I've been just doing a lot of studying on how we got here, you know, the 400 years of slavery, the Emancipation Proclamation, how we stayed in bondage in many different ways, how that, you know, years later, civil rights movement, Martin and Malcolm, and how the same exact things that Martin and Malcolm were upset about in the 60s are what we're facing today still, right?
Yeah.
What has happened over the last 40, 50 years on why we haven't progressed? Well, a lot of us, especially people like you and I, we've entertainment industry, we've been trying to work, right? We've been trying to make up for the economic disparity, trying to help with, and now when these things happen, you and I for the past 15 years have been going to marches together. You know what I'm saying? How many times have I seen you at these different rallies from Trayvon Martin to Eric Garner? Like, this happens all the time, and every time it happens and we see this and it gets worse and worse, it's like, where is our game plan? Why do we not have an agenda? And I think moving forward, whatever happens with this, it's going to be our responsibility to, like, influence that agenda. Like, we have to have some level of organization moving forward because this shit just keeps on happening.
Yeah, I mean, I think what we were talking about earlier is, you know, why we're not necessarily prepared right now. I said it was because we were distracted with business. We were distracted with our careers and, you know, just, you know, popping bottles in the club, having a good time, you know what I'm saying? We were curating our culture, you dig what I'm saying? And other people who had more of a malicious intent, they were planning and plotting, you know what I'm saying? We didn't have any malicious intent. We didn't have any reason to want to wage war against, you know what I'm saying? Well, we had reason, we had justification, but we just wasn't on that, right? So people were planning and strategizing a war against us back before we even knew it was a war going on. So that's why we're not prepared. Dig what I'm saying?
100%.
I think, you know what I'm saying? A lot of us, you know what I'm saying? A lot of us, myself included, you know, we've been spoiled with our luxuries. You dig what I'm saying? And it's easy to fall back and, you know what I'm saying, not really be focused on the things that you need to be focused on all the times that you need to be focused on them when you have so many luxurious distractions around you. You know what I mean? And not to mention, you know, social media don't make it no easier. You know what I'm saying? You can easily get caught in gossip. You get caught in lust. You get caught in all kinds of shit. Just take your eyes off of the goal, which is, you know what I'm saying, the liberation of our people as a culture, as a generation. And I don't think, you know, people right now, today, I don't see a race war. You know what I'm saying? I don't see a race war, bro. I see a war between decent and indecent people. You know what I'm saying?
Facts.
Between fair people and racist.
Yeah.
Fascist, racist, white supremacists. You dig what I'm saying? And ultimately, I know we don't have the strategy yet. I know we don't have the artillery, the training. But I'm going to tell y'all what, in this war, regardless of what the other side got, God is only going to fight with one of us.
1,000,000%.
You dig what I'm saying?
And God, that's going to be the side of just, you know? During the Obama administration, I spent a lot of time there, right? We were working on programs for education. We were working on programs for exercising, obesity problems in America, health issues. I never, during my time there, was thinking that, you know, there was we took our foot off the gas. I was unfocused on the fact that a war was going to be waged at us again, right? We kind of all got distracted, like you said, by the luxuries of life, by trying to progress as a people. And we completely missed the boat on the fact that they were planning and they're completely organized and we're not. And I think now is really the time for us to utilize this moment to mobilize, to get together, to prioritize what's important, and to really set an agenda on what needs to happen next moving forward, man.
I think that's going to all come into, I think, as long as you got people like you and I, I'm out here, you know, I just got off the phone with Mustafa and the minister, awaiting their insight and direction, you know what I'm saying? Just constantly, I know you out in L.A., man, surrounding yourself with people who can inform you and educate you on how to take the next steps forward. But shit, bro, as long as we care, as long as we continue to work diligently, man, and try to answer the questions that we don't have the answer to right now, it's gonna come.
And that's, you know, that's what I also tell people is like, we're making up for a lot of years of oppression. We're making up for a lot of years of misinformation. We're making up for a lot of years of not having books and not having, you know, the proper tools to act out. And so when we see all the disparities that are happening now, we're dealing with 400 years of backstory that led us to where we are today, man. So like you said, man, we care. We're on it. For everybody that's out there that posted the black screen today, you know, there was it seemed like a positive thing. Some people were saying it's negative. Like, I think right now it's two sides to this war, like you said. It's the decent and the indecent. And those with a moral fortitude and those without it. And it's like, over time, we're going to get to where we need to be. But right now, uniting, standing together, that's what's really important right now.
That's real. Hey, I mean, I think there's a collective effort. Everybody has a place and a purpose in this shit. You know what I mean? If everybody does a little bit, nobody has to do a lot. I mean, so I'm gonna just continue to try and do my part and support everybody else around me just doing their part.
Yup. All right, love it, man. And somebody just posted, why is a black square wrong? We're not saying a black square is wrong, so don't get that twisted. What we're saying is today is a primary vote day, and for a lot of us, we didn't have that information this morning. I didn't know about it. And now we want to make sure that people know how important it is if you're in one of those states to vote as well. So
it's I'm going to put it in my story. I'm
going to put that in our stories as well.
All the states that's voting today in my story.
Exactly. So part of what we're saying right now is just we got to keep communicating and get the information to each other. Tip, I love you. Get on about your day. I'll call you later, bro.
Already. Love and respect, bro.
Love, bro.